everyone. Thank you so much for joining me here today, again, at Bouchaine Winery and Vineyards in Napa Valley. It's a gorgeous day today, 85, sunny and clear blue skies over the vineyards, and I feel really grateful to be here to share my practice with you today and to guide you through yours. So I wanted to dedicate today's practice and kind of formulate the whole sequence around self-expression. I know that it can be sometimes a little tough given the current climate and state of affairs and personal life and difficulties to really feel the ability to release, to let things just exhale out of the body, to let things just flow and move through you, and to kind of also have a little space for self-expression. So while I did formulate the sequence myself, I would encourage you, if you wanted to adapt it yourself a little bit here and there, maybe with different arm variations, if you wanted to experience or explore with your own self-expression, feel free to play today, to use some of this space to kind of create different different things for whatever you need, whatever your body needs, and wherever you're at today. So let's get started on our mat. We're actually going to start with our legs, not in cross legs. We're going to take our right leg behind us. So making my left leg sits out front, my right leg is tucked behind. And so I kind of think of this leg shape as actually deer legs. I don't know how that got stuck in my head, but we'll start here with the right leg behind. We're going to put our left hand on our opposite knee and twist behind us very gently. Slowly kind of opening the spine here. Now take the hand that was behind you, go over the opposite side, keeping the left hand where it was. And put that right hand that was over the head, touch your own side of your face with it. Pull the neck to the side. Move the left hand next to your hip, just a gentle neck opener. And the other side, we'll actually move the feet now, so that's the opposite shape. My left leg is bent next to me, my right leg is kind of more flat laid in front. I'll put my right hand on my opposite knee and twist behind me. Another side body stretch, and for that I'm going to take my left hand and elbow, forearm drop to the mat, and reach the right arm over and arcing over the head. Opposite side, just kind of float down to the opposite. Arcing the left hand over the head. And come forward, extending the hands in front of you. Let's work on big breaths in the belly. Ask yourself to walk your fingers just a little bit farther on every exhale, just inching them forward.
butts into the floor. Slowly walk the hands back. We'll do just one little more twist. Just twist one way, looking behind you. And then twist the other way. So then we're going to get, you can just take your knees, walk forward, and we're going to come into that nice, stable position of table bump. We'll go through a few cat-cows, just dropping the belly low. And exhaling, curving the spine like a Halloween cat. Inhale and face the world, drop the belly. Push out of the hands, reach higher through the neck and shoulders. And exhale, curve the body, tuck the tailbone. Continue to push out of the hands, even taller, leaning more heavy. And then inhale, drop the belly low. A couple more times. Feel free to go a little faster if you want. Go at your own pace. Now from here, come to a neutral spine and take the right hand up in the air, your gaze will follow it, and then thread it through the hole that your left arm created, dropping the head to the mat and taking the right hand behind the back. Keep that top shoulder open still, opening the chest, not letting it drop towards the mat. And release. Coming back up to table. From that neutral spine, we're going to take our right leg up in the air, and we're actually going to do a little kind of push-up where we lower our chin to the mat, and then come back up, pushing up, curl that knee in towards the chin, in towards the nose, launch it back up towards the sky, and dip low. With the chin, push up, again, curl. Last time, releasing that foot up to the sky, lowering the chin, coming through, this time pulling the leg all the way through to a low lunge. Go ahead and help your foot inch forward if it needs it. So here in low lunge, use whatever hand position you want, whether it's your hands on your knees, your hands clasped behind your back, your hands above your head. Choose what you need today. How you want to express yourself. Really sink low, feeling this first hip opener, nice and deep. Whenever you're ready, release the hands to the mat, shift the body weight backward, extend that front leg nice and straight in Ardha Hanumanasana, half monkey pose. Also kind of a starter pose for the splits. If you can release your head towards the mat, towards you. Bend that front knee again, plant the left hand, lift the back knee, and twist. Plant both hands on either side of the foot. Draw your body in plank. And from here, actually, we're going to do lowering to our knees. Lower your chest and chin to the ground in Ashtanga Namaskara, eight limbs, honored pose. Then flatten the body out. Come on up, baby cobra. Pushing out of the hands, arching the spine gently. Elbows hugging the body, looking forward, lower down, and come back up to table. Here at table, we're going to do the opposite side now, doing everything on our left. So we'll start by lifting that left hand up towards the sky.
today. A lot of kind of lingering in the twist too, where we really explore that expression of the body and spine, being encouraged in different shapes.
We will unfold back of the table. We'll do that scorpion leg again. Push-ups. Get the leg lifted, lower the chin. Push the body up. Curl the knee to the nose. Scorpion leg back. Lower the chin. Come back. Curling the body. Last time. Lower. And pull the leg all the way through for the low lunge. Again, take any expression you want of the hands, whether on the interlaced behind back or above. Ready, lower, hands to the mat, straighten that front leg, nice and straight. Lower the head, chest towards that outreach leg. Just trying to reduce any tension you feel in that upper body. It's just a big, dramatic hamstring stretch. No tension and nothing else. And that knee forward. Plant the right hand, pop the back knee and off the mat. The twisted lunge. Frame the foot with the hands again. Pull both of the feet together into plank. Lower the knees, lower the chest, lower the chin. Straighten the legs, little cobra, push up, look forward, elbows hugged in, come back, this time come into a downward dog. As it's our first downward dog of the day, and of practice, let's bicycle our heels up and down. It's also called walking the dog. Right leg up to the sky, pull it forward in between the hands, plant the back heel, come up, warrior one. Express the hands how you wish, above, at the heart, behind, on the hips, take your variation. Now reach your arms above your head and point together and launch forward. Into flying pranam, where your body becomes an entire straight line, launching up warrior legs. Release the hands, interlace them behind your back, launch them forward, lower your chest, devotional warrior, humble warrior. Hold the hands, warrior two, float up, release the hands. Adjust the back foot so that it's at a nice parallel to the back edge of the mat. Adjust your side body so it's facing, the side is facing in front of you. It's not twisting forward. Side body faces the side. It is only the head, like a cherry on top, that twists forward. Twist towards the front and twist the hands. From here, this is a new pose. We haven't done it together yet. Straighten the front leg. Sweep the right hand towards the mat, come up on your heel, come forward now, it's only 1 second, we'll hold it, reverse warrior,
Really commit to that front bend in the front knee. Don't ease off. Commit to it. Now everyone meet with your hands in the air as we'll tilt forward, hinging of the hips, flying pranak. Interlace the hands behind your back. Launch them overhead. Devotional warrior. Readjust the back foot. Bend that front knee and again focus. I'm not letting the side body twist forward. This is not warrior two. Warrior two is with the shoulders, even the arms as straight as the leg, and the whole body and hips facing forward. It's only the head that turns. Again, the new pose, straighten the front leg, sweep the left arm towards the mat, towards the back heel. Back forward. Reverse your warrior into a beautiful, peaceful warrior. I like to look behind me at my back heel. Everything pinwheels or pinwheels. Forward. Right hand plants. Twist it. Lunge. Plant both hands on the mat. Come to a plank. Chaturanga, elbows hug, we look in front of us. We come up into upper dog, pushing out of the palms of the hands really firmly. And back, down the dog. We'll go through this flow again and build on it a little more. So you'll know what to expect. But of course, there'll be surprises. Beautiful flow and expression of self. Moving from strength to softness. Now float that right leg up in the air again. See where the kneecap is. Draw the leg in between the hands. Come up. Warrior one. Any expression. Arms up. Hinge forward. Flying. Devotional warrior. Float up, adjust the back foot. Warrior two, nice strong legs. Straighten the front leg. Sweep that right hand low towards the opposite heel. Float back upwards. Slide the back hand. Reverse warrior. Here, we're actually going to place our right elbow on our knee for side, for extended side angle. If you want to try a little deeper, place the right hand on the mat, launching the left overhead. Or maybe try for a bind even. Take the left hand behind the leg and take the right hand under. Grasping your own hands. From here, release the bind, place your right hand in front of you. We're going to hop, come forward, hop, 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 and set up right here for half moon. Ardha Chandrasana. You want the extra challenge? Go ahead and reach back to the top of your foot. Try to focus on keeping the side body open. Don't collapse it towards the mat. Try to look in front of you or up. Let go. Come back. Warrior two. Beautiful. Float both hands down to the mat. Right hand up. Twisted. And from here, see if you can come into rock star by taking that front foot behind you, launching hips to the ceiling, and come back into plank, back into chaturanga,
upward dog, a push up, and downward dog, push back. We're going to really enjoy this luxurious moment in downward dog. Imagine the stress melting from your head, dripping into the earth, maybe. Just letting go of all the tensions, feeling the fire starting to be burned. Left leg now up into the air. Don't let the hip rotate too much. Focus on the kneecap. Pull it forward now. Warrior one. Arms go up. Or in any variation. Flying pranam. Launch forward. Feel the energy shoot out of the fingertips and out of the back heel. Release the hands and release behind the back. Lower the chest. Float up, warrior two. Sink. Straighten the front leg. Sweep the left hand. Vertical rainbow warrior pose. And now we'll come back. Reverse warrior, peaceful warrior. Now the elbow goes onto the leg, launching into this extended side angle. If you want deeper, drop the top and the mat. If you want the bind, left hand goes through the hole of the leg, the bent leg, and the right hand goes through the back. And lift that top shoulder. Try not to collapse towards the mat. Really try to keep your heart open. From here, release the bind. Left hand in front. Pop, pop, pop. Hand on hip. And we're going to do the half moon. What I love about half moon is that it's half darkness and half light. It's a really beautiful pose that challenges the balance. It's the mind. Still expresses the body in so much grace with this launch of the body and extension. If you want to grab the back, top of the foot for full moon, go for that. It's a great stretch for the long. We'll drop back for a or two. Inhale the arms. Left hand floats up, twisted. Go for the rock star. The front foot slides behind you. Hips up. Arms long. Come into a beautiful, strong plank. Chaturanga. Look forward. Upward dog. Push the tops of the toes into the mat. And palms of the hands. And float back. And down your dog. Towards the ceiling or towards the sky. Drop the head, maybe even shake it, maybe even smile. Feel tension releasing. Feel things being let go. Bend the knees and either walk or maybe try to hop. Hop forward. Look up. Straight spine. And then we're going to fold towards the mat. Really releasing the hands. I'm going to hold for a few breaths. So really let go. Shift a little bit of the weight forward. Up to 60% actually, or 70 even. And test that body. Make sure no tension in the head or the neck. Give it a shake. Really milk this movement. So really go slow. Feel as if every vertebrae is clicking into place. Head up last. Hold the shoulders up. direction. When you think of expression, most people would think of your voice, right? Your ability to speak, your truth, to be honest, and to express through creativity, through your words and through your song, maybe. These things. So we'll do a few neck rolls. If you've noticed, we have involved the neck and the shoulders a lot to our practice today. So we can really massage this vocal or these vocal organs in our throat. This area that is associated with expression. It's also the center of a chakra point called the sudhi, which is located right in the center of our throat. From here, take your hands to your hips. Move the feet out about 10 inches apart, I like to say about the distance of two fists. From here with the hands on the hips. We straighten our spines and slowly bend forward. But if you notice, I'm bending really forward and I'm making an L shape. I'm not yet at all curving my spine. There's no, if you've noticed, none of that motion. Look at me, I'm not doing that. I'm really working on making this an extension out of the spine, straightening and lowering, hinging. I love that word. We really are hinging at the hips. We're releasing our hands to the mat and grabbing a hold of our big toes using the hooks of our middle finger and our pointer finger. And lower the head. Asana. Feet to finger bones actually is the translation. Again, really try to pull the chest, pull the body closer to the thighs. It's okay to bend the knees, absolutely, whatever you need, to really feel a beautiful stretch in the hamstrings. Release the fingers, stay exactly where you are, so slip our hands underneath our feet in Padahastasana, feet to hand pose, also sometimes called gorilla pose. Again, bend the knees as much as you need to work towards getting the chest closer to the thighs. Straight legs are not important. They don't deepen the stretch for you. It depends on your flexibility, so don't focus on it. Legs. That's not the expression of your body. How it is to me. And allow that and accept it. Release the hands, place them on the hips. We're going to kind of come back the way we came a little bit. We're curling the spine down again, kind of extending out a bit. There's a lot of blood in the head. Big, slow breath in and out. Challenge ourselves today with a nice strong balancing pose. So to prepare, get your left foot really spread, nice and wide, really prepare to like get every toe stretched before placing it on the mat. And then we're just going to take our right knee up towards our chest. Just cover. If you want to stay here, absolutely. If you want to reach forward with your left hand for the outside edge of your foot, extending that foot and twisting around us. Release, bend the knee again. And from here, I'm going to see if I can get to my foot. Maybe just stay here, or maybe extend the foot straight in front of you. Release. Tiptoes a few times, bend knees, do the opposite side, taking the right foot, maybe I'll do it from the side this time, no, maybe front, right foot, spread the toes, take that right knee and hug it, maybe you want to just twist back with the knee bent, to do garden pose, also called malasana, by getting your feet the distance of a little bit wider than the hips. Turn the toes out. From here, you're just going to bend your knees and squat low. So this pose is really great for detoxification, removal of negative energy, negative forces, releasing anything stuck. So whether you believe in the philosophy or the energy movement or the prana flowing through you, whether you believe it or not, or feel it or not, just know that that is the purpose of this pose. Maybe the purpose of practice today, just to let things go, stand in your own truth, in your own expression. I know this can be difficult to hold for too long. If you're noticing it's getting challenging, you can always straighten your legs, stand up, and try to come right back. We're only going to hold it for another few more breaths. My folded leg is not on top of my knee, keeping that in mind. You never want to put pressure on that joint. So it's bent in half cow face. I will flex that outstretched foot, put my hands on either side of my leg, and bend forward. You can extend your hand if it's more comfortable. You notice that this is a tiny movement. It doesn't look impressive, but there's so much going on in it. I feel it really dramatically in my outstretched leg, in the left leg. Feel it behind the knee and in a bit of that hamstring. Some people feel it more in this bent leg, in their hips, their hip flexors. Every body is different. From here, plant that foot that was on top, and we're going to do that twist. So either stay here, bend the leg underneath you again. The left hand will come to the slowly lower the chest towards the thighs. Drop the head towards the knees. Take any variation of the hands you need. So really, you have to look at the ceiling, you have to look straight. So if you want to watch me first, go for that, and then try it yourself. Just please don't twist the neck and shoulder stand. It's pretty extreme on the neck, on the delicate cervical spine, so we really want to make sure we're protecting that by not moving our neck. So from here, either you can come into bridge, right? This is your option. Come into supported bridge with your hands on your hips. Or in Sarvangasana, we're going to kick our feet up, adjust the shoulder blades, and kind of try to inch our hands closer to our upper ribs. So I'm not hugging my hips, you can probably see that, but I'm actually putting the pressure in the upper back, or middle back, as high up as I can. Together, body is in as straight of a line as possible. Go ahead, release the body slowly. Extend the legs. Fish pose. Bend the elbows behind the back. Land it on the ground and release the top of the head towards the mat. This is the counterbalance. Toes, one last kind of counterbalance pose I think was really nice to do after shoulder stand. You can see I'm not doing this very deep, I'm just really gently reaching forward. And then I'll roll slowly down towards the mat. Bend the knees, and on the mat. And let's hug our knees. Celebratory hug for that expression. Sarvangasana is one of the best poses for your throat chakra, for that source of expression and creativity. As it puts so much pressure on it, it's almost like a massage. It's so stimulating that it helps encourage energy for upflow and prana to go through it. From here, move your arms into a T shape. And let's just drop the knees to the right. I'm going to look left. I'm going to do a few of these windshield wiper movements. So I'm going to look to the right as I drop them to the left. Again, it's windshield wiper. the right knee up towards the face, but we come from the side. You notice I do not pull my knee directly towards my face. I kind of arc it, swoop it out to the side, and hug the knee into the chest, grabbing hold of your elbows if you can. Now exhale every bit of air. Finish your exhale, release the leg down to the mat, to the opposite side, swooping the left leg up towards the face, hugging in the knee to the chest, and then exhale every bit of air. And finish the exhale, release the leg, and we'll do both. Again, coming from the side, sweeping both legs out before coming in. Hug them to the chest. Release all oxygen, all the stale air, get every last ounce out. And release the legs down towards the mat. We'll take our right knee up in the air. Asana before Shavasana, right? The universal spinal twist. Take the left hand connected and pull it over the body. Right hand connects, pulls it to the side, the left hand extends, I look to the left, and I allow my body to become the shape. I don't resist it, I don't fight it, just let gravity help me to get where I need to be. Lay heavy in Shavasana. Allow the body to just kind of find a comfortable shape where the fingers can spread a little bit comfortably, the toes and the feet move away from each other. Nothing is being clenched or activated. It's just very heavy, relaxing pose, Shavasana. Slowly start